stress, a lot of pain, a lot of strain, a lot of overwhelming passion we have when we try to do what we have to do on a daily basis. I'm talking about them bills, y'all, the bills that we accumulate on a regular basis. I know I'm doing all you can. I know you're doing all you can. This is Authentic Epic Boom. Hey, boomers, are you booming today? I hope so. This is part two of Financial Woes. I know it's bad when you feel like if you spend a dollar, you're afraid to do that. To forget something, to forget a bill. No matter what, they always coming. I got something today from the police department about a commission for a permit for my alarm that I have. I told you guys I have AT&T Digital Life, so that's another bill now. But you know, I'd rather pay that because I want to be safe. I want to feel safe. Whatever makes you feel safe or make you feel more at peace, do what you got to do. But at like with anybody, I am struggling paycheck to paycheck, one check away from being homeless. My lashes or my, you know, eyebrows, I do myself. I watch a lot of YouTubers. I'm a YouTuber, but I'm a YouTube fan. So it's a lot of things I come up with, a lot of things I watch that I'm curious about. And I know the difference between a need and a want. So my wants can be put to the side. You know what I mean? I can't put my wants to the side. That's what most people would say. I know people that would say that. I can't put my wants to the side. There's people I know that claim they broke, but they taking trips to places internationally. How can you? Well, that's on them. I can't do stuff like that. I don't know people that really can do stuff like that, but it's like I'm thankful for all I go through. I pray every day that it gets better. I just try to do a lot of stuff myself, you know, and I try to rethink, re-strategize. I'm always constantly thinking. I like process thinking is what I call it. And we're doing what we can. But it's stressful when you feel like you can't go out. I love being at home, but I'm more active and like to be out, and I can't do the things I used to do. And there's a lot of things I miss, like, oh, on that bucket list. Look, we need to, y'all come closer. Because this is a conversation that needs to be had. And we should be having on a regular basis. It's like, do you feel like you have to sacrifice to where you can't go out to a movie or out to eat? I feel like my Starbucks is my crack. That's the thing that I have. I play games like COVID fashion that helps me kind of get out of my head sometimes. But finances can even affect your health. I need to have a hysterectomy. That's something I will get into a later time. But I don't have anybody in my life that's going to come and be here. The doctor said at first, rehab, I would have been fine. But he said, after a couple of days, I'll just send you home. Home to who? I live by myself. And when it comes to bills and responsibilities, it's all me. It's not like I got a family I can go to. I don't even want that. To each his own, if you have that, that's good for you. I don't personally have that. I have me and God. So with that being said, I have to put that off until I can figure it out, figure out my insurance. And if I can get a nurse here for when I need to do that. So finances is even to the point where you have to worry about your health, which is very important because your health comes before anything. And I think sometimes the stress that we go through gives us headaches. I think I have not been feeling good because of the stress. I pray a lot. I try to do whatever, okay, I can to make ends meet. And a lot of us know that's not enough. It's not enough. So when you do all, what do when you do all you can and it's still not enough? That part right there frustrates the shit out of me. We sacrifice. We do all we can to provide. And it gets to the point where I know I done been in plenty of food banks before. I done been in here with no food. I done been in here, can't eat even stuff I want to eat. Or let me rephrase that. Eating stuff that I usually like to eat, but I'm eating it so much I can't keep it down. Or trying to figure out what am I going to do to get this bill not turned off because I can't keep up with everything. And I know a lot of you guys feel that you can't keep up with everything. You're praying, you're doing all you can, you got a second and third job. I do gigs, I do all I can, and it's still not enough. That's where my frustration comes in at, and all we can do is pray, try to motivate each other. You guys, let me know what you're going through. The struggles, the strides, whether you got a family, whether you're by yourself. Well, if just in grown adults, we go through so much. We don't have that silver spoon like I talked about. We're not the Kardashians and all this other stuff we see on TV or we hear what these rappers talk about. You know, speaking of shows, that show Payday that I told you guys about. And it's interesting, they go to different cities and they see how people live and try to strive or see people's come ups. This one guy's a rapper. He signed to Yo Gotti, I forgot his name, but he walks around, y'all, with 70K in his pocket. Because he said, I'm from the hood and I'm not used to having money. That's deep, I get it, but at the same time, we have to be careful. Because while you flow showing and doing that, somebody could rob and kill you of that. Then you won't have your life for nothing else. So I think about stuff like that and how sometimes people become rich, they come down, you know, and they have to start all over again. People with degrees, like ourselves, we have to take jobs less than or take less pay just to make sure we can do what we have to do to live. Living is hard and it's stressful. It also can be cool and stuff, but financial woes is just really a daunting task that we are, us as individuals, learn we have to deal with. And with that being said, I did want to tell you guys something else. I think that's it for now. Let me know how you're doing, what's going on. Thank you for viewing me. Please come back and see me. Anybody subscribe to me, I subscribe to you, whether you got a channel or not. That's just me. And I love the fact that we connect. Please let me know if there's anything you want us to talk about. And I'm here. I'm listening. My ears are wide open. And I'm going to leave you with this.